All right, so now we're up to where do we where do we leave off? Oh, on the bottom of Pei Dalan with base. All right, talking about all the different ways of kinyonim. Right, so yesterday we got finished with discussing. Well, the truth is, okay, we'll just mention it's not negated today's daf, but yesterday it said the Gemara was talking about how you can do kinyonim, right? Can you do a kinyon in Rosh Hashanah? So we said you can't do a kinyon in Rosh Hashanah. You can do a kinyon in a simta, right? A simta is okay. We weren't sure exactly what how that worked, right? How that simta worked, but how to being kind of Okay, but now we go on to a different sugya. So Rav, bottom line, well, we're starting on Rav Shmuel Damri Tavai. Fine, that's
I realized this morning, excuse me, Yaakov,
yeah.
that when they changed the laws about the bags, so we bring our own, some stores, you bring your own bags. So when the girl puts the stuff in your bags, aren't you kind of already before you pay her? You don't have to pay her. What do you have to
What
pay her
change?
for? Or I bag
What?
it myself. Right, you go into what's it called, a Kol Save, right?
Right.
So you bring your own bags, and they and you and she and she's handing them to you. So you put them in a bag. What do I have to pay the guy for? I was kind of it before I paid him. It's in my bag, he told me to bring my bag.
You mean you didn't do it? Yeah, but he is not giving it to you.
But Baron, I guess what? You could try it. You'll be the last time you go back there. You'll get
Well, I never got
arrested.
there
You'll get
anyways. I might as
arrested.
well try it one time.
You'll
Right?
get arrested.
No,
That
I'm
makes
saying it
sense.
doesn't.
Why would I be arrested? They gave me the food. They told me to put it in my bag.
They didn't tell you don't have to pay.
It makes not paying worse, the fact that you're kind of it. Because now it's a milveh. Now it's a loan. It's a lav
Why is
not to
it
pay back the
alone?
loan.
Why is it alone?
Because that's the agreement that you made when you were kind of it.
I didn't make an agreement with nobody. Why did I make
But
an
you
agreement?
certainly,
Now that's a
I
lot of
sure
the
did
right
not
thing.
own it.
I picked things off the shelf and they told me to put it in my bag.
They
So I
didn't say
did
it's
that. Now I'm
free.
going home.
They
No, no,
didn't
no.
say it's
No one told you
free.
that.
It belongs to
No.
them. Now it belongs to you. That's called gzeila. If it's not gzeila, then you owe them money. That's a
No, he's
lot of
asking
not
what
paying back.
thing. They
No,
told me to put it in my bag. They didn't tell me to pay him yet.
I think no. Enochanami. It has to be that we're talking about where the person has the das to be maknit. If he doesn't have the das to be maknit, I could put into my rishus for all I want. Who cares? Well, we're gonna see that more into we're gonna see more in
Okay.
today in tonight's stuff. More on oh maybe
Well,
tomorrow. Probably both. Yeah, let's see how it goes. So Rav Shmuel, Damri Tarvayu. So Rav Shmuel both say, and now this is gonna last for the entire daf, this sugya here. Kalev Shalom, Antam Pehe Amar Aleph. Kalev Shal Adam Koinele Bechol Makom. Right, the Kalem of a person is kind of for him anywhere. I mean, you can chutz mirishus harabim, except for just around, like Rav Aaron is saying. Well, first, if he brings his own bag, right? He brings his own bag, right, from home, and then you go to the grocery store and they start putting into your bag. So your bags are kinda, except rishus harabim, right? So it sounds like even in the rishus of the seller, it works as a kinyan, but just not in rishus harabim. Rav Yochanan, Rav Shimon, Lagash, Damer, Afilu, rishus harabim, even in rishus harabim. Right now, you're right. When you read this Gemara, it sounds like okay, yeah, so then I could just go be kind of things. No, but you're gonna need the das, you need a das machna, you need a das machna also. Right? But we'll see more on that in Gemara. But the bottom line is the machloikis, Rav and Shmuel against Rav Yochanan and Rish Lakish. That's called a powerhouse machloikis. Right? Two that are normally chaylik on each other are agreeing with each other against each other. Right? Rav and Shmuel against Rabbi Yochanan and Rish Lakish. Right? Okay, so I'm a Rapapa. So Rapapa, then Rav, what?
Nothing.
Yeah. Then Rav Papa comes along, and we know from Rav Papa, Naftali, you on?
Yes, I'm on. Yeah, I'm on.
Caught you. Rav Papa, see, Rav Papa's making peace in between Rav and Shmuel, Rav Yochanan, and Rish Lakish.
Right, we said Rav Papa. I don't remember the word. We said Rav Papa is. That's why he's mentioned in the Siyam.
That's why all the Bar Papas are mentioned in the Siyam. I think Rabbi Yashiv said a Pshat and Gemara and Brochus. It's one of Tali's favorite Pshatim from the Daf. That's why I'm He said that since the Papas were always looking to make non-machlaikis, so therefore they made it into the Siyum. Anyway, so I'm a Papa, like Pliggy, there's no machlaikis. Kambrish Rosarabim, Kambistim, to one is talking about Rosh Hasarabim.
I can't argue Chas V'Shalom on Rabbi Yashiv. But so what? How does he explain that the reason we learn Gemara is the smallest blot has five machlokes? Every blot in Shas has machlokes.
Right. No, but ultimately we're looking not to have machlokes. No.
I have no idea. I don't know why you say that.
I hear you have a valid point. You have a valid point, but yes, but yeah. But anyways. Summer up, a light pliki, kam Rosh Hasarabim, kam Pesimta. They have one is talking about Rosh Hasarabim. So in a real Rosh Hasarabim and a Hanami, you can't be kainit. But in a Simta, he can. Right? By my corollary, Rosh Hasarabim. So then why are you calling it a Rosh Hasarabim? Right? Meaning, they both say Rosh Hasarabim. Rav and Shmuel say Rosh Hasarabim. Rabbi Yochanan and Rish Lakish say Rosh Hasarabim. Right? So am I correlating Rosh Hasharabim? Shein Rosh Hayachid. It doesn't mean it's really Rosh Hasharabim. It means that it's not a Rosh Hayachid, right? So Hachanami Mistavra, that makes sense. The Gemara says, "Damar Abavo, Amar Rav Yochanan, Kelo Shel Adam Kainalai, a person's Kelim are kainif for him. B'chol Makam Sheyesh Rosh Hashanichai, and any place that he has permission to put it." Yesh le rishus in, ain le rishus loy. If he has rishus to put it there, then good. Ain le rishus loy. If he doesn't have rishus, then it's not. So shmami no. So therefore, we hear from this that's where the machloikis is. Meaning when person, an asimta, like we said yesterday, asimta is an alleyway, off rishus ram. There, everybody has permission to put things down. Right? So mamela. That you, since they have permission, so we're calling that, that's what we're calling a Rishus Harabim, because everybody has the Rishus to put it down there. Okay, fine. So that's, now the Gemara is going to try from a long brisa to prove. The Gemara is going to try and prove this. So Tana Rabbanan, Arba Midas B'Meichrin, there's four Midas by sellers. Was that the Lashon in the Mishnah? Didn't we also have two Mishnahs ago? Arba Midas B'Meichrin. Yeah, that was the Lashon. It's an interesting use of words. No Midas? Yeah, okay, but anyways, this is not the same as the Mishnah. This is a whole different list. So Arba Midas B'Meichrin, there are four midas by Meicher, right? Actually, Nesmala Midala Meicher, before they fill up the measurements, then it goes to the Meicher, meaning you go to the bar. Let's talk in one that we can understand. You go to the bar, and he's filling up your cup of beer. And then you say, you know what? I don't want beer. Right? So do you have a right to backtrack, or do you not have a right to backtrack? So before it's filled up to the measurement, then the Meicher has the right to back out. Right? Mishin is Mala Mida Lekeach. Once the Mida was filled up, so then it goes to the Lekeach. Right? Meaning, that's it. He bought it. That's only talking about where the cup that they're using doesn't belong to both of them, meaning it's a neutral cup. Aval im haisa mida shel echad mehen, but if the mida belongs to one of them, then rishon rishon kaina, then as each bit goes into the cup, that will be kainid for him. Right? Meaning, if the cup belongs to the seller, then he's then even the cup, the all everything, all the beer that's in the cup still belongs to him. Right? It's until the buyer picks up the cup. And if it belongs to the buyer, then the whole thing goes to the buyer and the seller cannot back out. Right?
What happens if it's the buyer's bucket, but his child underage is carrying it for him? People used to send their kids into bars with a pail before they invented cans and everything. Send the kid into a bar with a pail, and he would pour the beer into the kid's pail. The kid would take it home to his father.
Right. So what are you saying?
The kid's not bar mitzvah yet.
You're saying, so when does the kinyan happen?
Yeah.
Does he have the das to be maknet?
He has the das to be maknet.
Yeah. I don't know how it would work with the cotton, yeah?
What's the difference?
A cotton can't be kaina.
He's not the one being kaina.
You mean it's the kli? Yeah. You say it's the kli is being kaina.
You might need chaser mishtameris. Is that considered chaser mishtameris if it's in Rishus Rav? Or if it's in...
No, the Shilas is the kli kaina.
But how is the kli kaina?
But that, Rabar, that's
the kli is kaina as a yad?
Yeah.
What does that mean? It's not his. Yad. Whose yad is it?
The father of this kid.
The father's not here. How's it his yad?
He doesn't have to be here.
How's it his yad if he's not here?
It's
Chatzar. It's kind of
out of Chatzar, probably. So it's not Chatzar Mishnah Meris. Well, that's what we're trying. Well, that is the sugya that we're trying to figure out.
I understand, but to say he's kind of out Yad, there's no where. Who's Yad?
Right.
Okay.
Well, okay. Let's see the whole. Let's see the whole sugya over here. All right. But that's what we're trying to handle, whether somebody's kli can be kainit for him. So basically what we're saying here is if the kli, depending on who the kli belongs to, if it's a neutral kli, then it's going to depend on when it gets filled up and when it doesn't get filled up. If the kli belongs to the meicher or the lekeach, then the kli, as it gets full, it belongs to whoever owns the kli. Fine. Now, Bamed Dvarim, one of the Gemara says that's Rishus Harabim or Chatzar Shein Shel Shneim. This is talking about when it's in Rishus Harabim or a Chatzar that doesn't belong to either one of them. So now you see that the Chatzar has the Kli has something to do with the Chatzar. Rishus Meicher. But if it's in the seller's property, like Kana Achi Yigbana, he's not kind of the cup until he picks it up. Right? See, that's so Rabban, what you're saying there. So I don't know when the guy will be kainit, because has he been kainit, right? If it's in the cup is in the rishus of the seller, right? Or until he takes it out of his rishus, right?
That's rishus. Taking out of his rishus. Is that mashicha or is that the kenyan of the kli? Once the kli is outside, the kli is kainit. If I said none of this has anything to do with Das Kaina. We have Das Kaina, we have. We just need a Hechatimsa for the Kenyan to happen. That's the point.
Okay. All right, but the point is that let's stick without the Das Kaina. Let's try and keep it simple. Right? So we're getting out the Das Kaina, right? But point is, we have to know physically whether it even works. So we're saying now that it will not work in the Rishus of the Meicher until he picks it up or until he pulls it into his Rishus. right? But Rishus Lekeach, but let's say the cup is in the Rishus of the Lekeach, given Shekibel Lelav Moicher, since the Moicher was Makabal and himself Kona Lekeach, the Lekeach is Kona. But Rishus Halah Hamufkodim Etzloy, and then if, let's say it's in the Rishus of somebody who's a Mafkir, who's watching the, he's watching the stuff, the beer, right? Meaning the guy is a portable bar, and this guy happens to be manning the bar. Right, so Mamela loikona achi yikabel a love until the shomer, the mafkid, not the mafkid, the shomer is makabel on himself ayachi yischaras makayme, or until he rents the place where the stuff is. Right, that's when the kinyan happens. Right, so whatever. So okay, so now that there's a whole lot of variables of when kalim are kaina and when kalim are not kaina. Fine. So katani mia. So what do we want with all this? What we learned in this whole case? What does the Brisa say? That if it's in the Rishus HaRabim and in a chotzer that doesn't belong to both of them, what does that mean? What's a chotzer that doesn't belong to the both of them? My love, Rishus HaRabim, mamish. It must mean it's a mamish in Rishus HaRabim. Right? And we said that it's going to be kind of him, right?
Well, yeah, I'm sorry. Just hit me. I apologize.
Yeah.
Rishus HaRabim, the same. We had the sugi now about the talus for slichus. You can't use the shul's talus because you're a partner in the shul's talus. You have to use a prophet's talus, yeah.
I mean, you could use it, but you just don't, you might not make a bracha, right?
Yeah. So what is Rishus HaRabim? Why aren't we all partners of Rishus HaRabim? We all pay taxes to the city. So why aren't we partners in the Rishus HaRabim?
Yeah, so that's a good question. Meaning, who says that we should be in, meaning... Basically, you're asking what's the Rishus HaRabim and a Simta, because we said a Simta.
Yeah, I mean,
the
Rishus HaRabim becomes a new entity because, or is it something that's owned by you? Everybody in the city decides to pay money and they built a park. So they all own part of the park.
That's because you pay taxes.
Or is the city a separate entity? The city owns the park now.
Right. So I think the pshat is that if it's not exclusive for your usage, not mamish exclusive, because the simta is not exclusive either, right? Meaning a guy can't kick you out of there whenever he wants.
I think
simta, you could go on the side of a simta and unload your bags and take a rest, whatever. You can't do that in Rishus HaRabim.
I mean, you could. You're just taking a risk. No.
No, I'm saying you'll be chayiv if you're mazik somebody.
Oh, that's so. Yeah, that's true.
No, I'm saying you can't.
And a simta, you're not.
Simta, I don't know. I'm not sure that's together. I'm not so sure that that's together.
Yeah, I'm just trying to bring out the point that, I mean, it's a good question, but I think a simta, you have more, I don't know of a good modern day example, but yeah, you have more, it's more, it becomes more Yerushus when you're in the simta than Rishus HaRabim.
Why?
Yeah, but I thought you always explain.
What halachically is changing in the simta?
It's a good question.
Yeah, well, it's not clear. We're not clear from yesterday's stuff. What does a simta do? Other than that, since people can have private conversations in the simta, so memela, it's considered more private. That's the
idea. If I can have a private conversation in a bus booth, then all of a sudden it becomes a
thing. It's like pulling over the shoulder on the freeway. You could stop your car there. You can't stop in the middle of the freeway.
Right. So therefore makes it that kinyanim work a little better. What are you saying, Akiva?
Why? Yeah.
I thought we always explained Rishus HaRabim that the difference between Rishus HaRabim and Simta is that Rishus HaRabim, yes, everyone has a right to it, but you don't have a right to use it exclusively for yourself if I'm there also. Meaning you can't just say I'm gonna create kinyanim here. Everyone else has a right to it, and therefore by you like trying to carve out your own space there to make a kinyan, that you don't have a right to do. You have a right to use it in a public manner. A simta, since it's already, it's more quiet there, and it's a place that not as, and even though it is Rishus HaRabim technically, since it's a place that's quieter, it's sort of like the Rabim gives you
the Rabbim is noicha for you to go ahead and make kinyanim there. Meaning they won't, they're not as makbid on you using a shared space for your private kinyanim.
But Akiva, what makes it so in Central Park, right, in the forest?
What Akiva said is essentially what the Rashbam says yesterday on Amud Beis. The Rashbam explains it almost exactly like that. The fact that one is allowed to put kalim down in one place and not in the other changes the halakha. If I'm allowed to put kalim down, and that's what it's designed for, then my kli has a space there. If my kli has a space there, it can be kaina.
Your kli would be bottle to a space that's not yours.
We define the symptoms as a little alleyway. Central Park in New York is huge, and you can put down your blanket and you can do whatever you want there.
Yeah, that would work as a symptom, L'chaira.
Yeah, but I'm just saying,
why,
Slav Dafka,
so why does that change
the side Shmigegi place?
It's what they're designed for. It's a design difference. The Rishus HaRabim, a true Rishus, a street, is designed for people to pass by. It's a thoroughfare. People move in Rishus HaRabim. You don't stop. A simta is somewhere that's designed to stop and therefore put Kalin down. Since
Central
it's designed
Park
for that,
under the tree, right? Central
is
Park.
The simta. That's what I just said.
So good.
Yeah,
but why does that change the halacha?
Oh, but that's what we're asking. How does simta work? Halacha?
Yeah, why does simta change the mechanics of kinyan? That's what
it's
I'm
sort
saying.
Of like
because
what Akiva.
Because it's designed to put kalim down there, the kalim have a mukim there. If I'm allowed to put my kli down and it's supposed to be there,
so how does that work halachically?
It's your temporary property for that.
Right.
For that
right.
Time.
Right.
It's like in your
Rishus. Let me ask you something. If I want to build a garage on a simta, could I do that?
No, that's not what it's designed for. Zev,
now you're getting into the joke. You build a sukkah and there's just a ram, and the judge gives you 8 days to take it down. That's if we want to get to that joke. That's the one.
Did somebody cut out their own driveway and you're not happy about it? Did one of your neighbors cut out a driveway? Is that the problem here?
No, well, I mean, it's just asking the halacha. Why is doing.
Akiva, don't get involved in black politics, Akiva. Okay?
Aaron, you got an extra driveway? What happened?
Okay, they want to finish the shiur. Call me later. We'll discuss that.
Thank you. The halacha is based on what it's designed to do. What is the use of this spot? Same as the difference between Rishus HaYachid and Rishus HaRabim. My property is designed for me to use however I see fit. Rishus HaRabim is designed for everyone to use and everyone to let everyone else use. No one has a right there. Simta is designed for me to take a break from the Rishus HaRabim and put my stuff down so I can invest a little
bit. So why does that make the Kenyan?
Once I have Rishus to put it down, then my Kli is not a Rishus HaRabim anymore. My Kli is a Rishus HaRabim.
Why does putting it down make it?
The ability to put it down means that the Rishus HaYachidness of my Kli can now act as a Rishus HaYachid. In Rishus HaRabim, since I can't do that, and the next guy that's walking past can walk straight through my Kli and trample it, my Kli is not my Rishus. Whereas in the Simta, since I have a right to put it down, no one can run over my Kli. Therefore, my Kli can act as my Rishus.
So if I run over your Kli in a Simta, am I Mechuyev to pay you?
Yes.
Yeah, because it's... Right when because Gershon owned that spot for that period of time.
It's not really owning. You have the rights. You have the rights.
It's Yaakov. The Rashbam says a very
So Yaakov, if I on the beach in Far Rockaway did a mechira, whatever it is, I did a kinyan, so it would work. But if I did it in Long Beach, it wouldn't work for me because I'm not allowed to do anything on the beach because I'm not a resident of these Kleinekep Long Island towns. In New York City, they're brighter people. Anybody in the whole world could come to New York City and use the beaches.
including the migrants.
I'm not talking about migrants. Okay. Now you're this plane that kept Long Island, you can't use the equipment, it wouldn't work because you're not allowed to be there.
All right. I don't know.
What are you saying? The Lashon is?
The Rashbam says a Lashon. Let's say the Meicher's Kli is in the Lekeas Kli. So the din is that you could automatically be kind of right away. And the Rashbam says over there, the reason why the Kli doesn't block your Chatzar from being kind is because the Kli is Batal Eitzel his Rishos. Which means that if it's not your Rishos, the Hainu or Rishos Rabbam, which is not exclusive to my Rishos, my Kli has no power to be kind of anything. Because it's Batal to the Rishos that I don't have a business having it in. So a simta, it's not bottled to, therefore the kli could act as a, whatever, you want to call it a chutz or whatever it is. It could act as a as a receptacle to be kind of something. But if it's not my rishos, the hainu amaychers kli, no lekeach's rishos, it is bottled to the rishos, it doesn't block my chutz or for me and kind of. So any kli that's in the wrong rishos, if it's in somebody else's rishos, is bottled to the rishos. That's what the response mashma when it comes to the kli maycher
birshos. That's interesting.
So similarly, you could apply the same yisari to rishos rabim. My kli can't act as a chutzah or as a receptacle to be kaina because it's bottled to the rishos rabim. It's not exclusively my rishos.
I hear that. And okay, that's a Akiva, you said it over well. Very good. Anyway, it's somewhere in no man's land. But either on the top of the omer now on pay hey on the bay. So my love rishos rabim mamish. It sounds like that the kalim of a lekeach, of the right, the buyer's kalim, if you put it into there in Rishus HaRabim, you kind it. Right? That's a kash on Rav and Shmuel. Rav and Shmuel said that it's not going to be kind it in Rishus HaRabim. So Gemara answers, lie, simta, it's talking about a simta. Right, the same way we said that a simta were a simta yesterday, we said a simta's like this no man's land like we just discussed. So the same thing here. But the Gemara says, v'adumi d'chotza she'en ha'shoshneim katani. But it says, the Braisa said Rishus HaRabim and a chutzah that doesn't belong to both. Right? Isn't that a Rishus HaRabim? A Rishus HaRabim is something that doesn't belong to both. So Gemara answers, my chutzah she'en ha'shoshneim nami. What does it mean a chutzah that's ain't ha'shoshneim? Deloi ha'ikula v'loi da'ha'ikula. Meaning they don't own the entire thing. Ela the tarvayu belongs to both of them. Right? So meaning the chutzah that the Gemara is saying, a chutzah she'enu shel shneim, is really means a chutzah of shutvus. It's both of theirs, right?
That's a real epoch.
Why?
You went from a chutzah she'enu shel shneim to a chutzah shel shneim.
Well, it's a little bit of both, because each guy, they don't totally own it, and they both totally own it, so...
Yeah, that fits in with Rav and Shmuel together and Reish Lakish together.
Right. The last price we had yesterday, the last one on our days, compared the Chatzah Shel Shneyan to Simta and the Chatzah She'eda Shel Shneyan to Rishus HaRabim. Here we say that the Chatzah She'eda Shel Shneyan, which is compared to Rishus HaRabim, which we said is Simta, is now Chatzah Shel Shneyan.
Right. But anyway, so it's somewhere in no man's land. But the point is that a chutzah she'enu shel shneim is talking about, well, it's not mamash or simta, but it's something like that, right? Yeah. Okay. Good. So now the Gemara says, "Bami nei Rav Sheshes mei Rav Huna Kelim shes lekeach b'rishus meicher." So now, what about Kelim of the lekeach that are in the shus of the meicher? This sounds like your case, Rav Aaron. The guy sends his jug of whatever to fill up the beer from the bar, right? So it's the Kelim, and the Rashbam says we're talking about where they obviously made up a price. That answers your kasha too, Rabban. That's the Rashbam saying. Don't think you just sent your kelim. They had to make up a price. They made up a price, right? So kelim shekem rishus meicher. Kana lekeach eloi. Is the lekeach koined or not? Right? What's the lumdus behind this? The Rashbam has some lumdus here, right? Meaning, is it pshat that the air, like the when it falls into the kli, that becomes his chatzar? Right? Or do we say no? The whole thing is in the Rishus of the Meicher, so therefore, it's still considered Rishus of the Meicher. That's the Gemara Shilas. Amar Le Tenisu, we learned it. Zarku lo l'say cheka, if a man is trying to divorce his wife. So there's an issue. When a man is divorcing a woman, everything she has belongs to the husband. Right? So if everything she has belongs to the husband, so how do you give her a get? Right? So what do you do? So Zarku lo l'say cheka, if you threw it into her lap, or into her basket, then she's considered divorced, because that's considered her own chatzar. So it's either going to...
Isn't this different? Because I don't need her to. I don't need to agree to this. I don't need her. I could just throw it at her, and she's divorced. Once it's in her rishus, she's divorced.
Right.
By this mocher, we both have to agree that this is happening. Otherwise, it doesn't work. We have to agree on a price. We have to agree. And then how am I koneh? But it can't be koneh without both people consenting. The woman is not consenting to this.
No, what everybody gets, she is.
She's not consenting to it. I just have to throw it in her rishus and then she gets it.
Right. Right. Well, and this is the rishus, no?
But that's not consent. I can divorce her without her consent.
The mechanics of the kinyan are the same though.
We're not getting into das,
machna das, kaina. The mechanics is what we're talking about. How does a kinyan work? What does it need to work? Okay. Physically.
Okay. And so what does it need? If it's not that, if she doesn't own the thing, you never gave it to her.
If she doesn't own her lap?
I presume she's wearing clothes, so it landed on her dress, not her lap.
No, that's what the Gemara is really going to discuss. Right, let's see how the Gemara says the Tirutzim. Right? But that's what the Gemara is saying. So you see that she's in the Rishus of her husband, yet we say the get is a get. So isn't that like into the Kalim of the Lekeach, the Rishus, and the Meicher? Right? So she's Megoreshus. So Amalei Rav Nachman. So Rav Nachman told him back, my time Peshat to Lemehi. Why are you saying Peshat from there in Gittin? The Machula Meo Uchli Ba'Uchlo. They already beat it 100 times with an Uchlo. An Uchlo is some sort of a weight or something like that. Right? Meaning we have a million different He's saying we have so many different Peshatim as to what this is. To what we're saying here, yeah. Meaning why it works by a get. It has to be where the basket is hanging on her. That's how it works, right?
See, why don't Gemara just say she was kind of in a simta? Forget about all these fancy ways of saying, you know, it's not it's a din hakbo, whatever it is. Why don't Gemara just say it's in a simta, and you have no proof. Like we did before.
I mean, why just stop and say that's a symptom? Yeah.
We had the exact same child before, Lagabi, the other case, that you're kind of rishus rabim, so you're kind of a symptom. There you don't have rishus meicher.
Right. I hear. I don't know.
Another guy doesn't want to divorce his wife where people are around. Going in the house.
Maybe you think that.
I mean, he's throwing it into her lap like it's no big deal.
Yeah, but they're in their yard. They're in their backyard, no?
It's normal to throw it into her lap like it's a piece of paper. I'm saying the case is a strange case as it is.
Correct.
You're talking about the normal way of divorcing your wife. It's not by throwing it into her basket.
You want to get rid of her. That's it. Get out of here.
No? Okay, so once you're going that far, why don't you just say he did it in a simta?
Right, I hear. I don't know, Enochanami. Okay, but he's saying this is one teretz there. It doesn't really work, but it works because it was hanging on her. The basket was hanging on her. As long as it was tied to her, even if it wasn't hanging, meaning it could be on the floor, as long as it's tied onto her. Ravada Barava Omar, Kigoin Shahisa Kalsam Nechas Laben Yar Kasa. It's talking about where it was between her legs. Right? Meaning she was like sitting on the floor. And meaning in that much a husband gives to his wife, that that area belongs to her. Right? It's talking about where the husband he sold these baskets. So she has a basket, who cares? He doesn't bother her so much. Rabbi Yochanan Amar, Makaim Chazaka Kanila. I'm sorry, Chazaka. Makam Cheka Kanila. Her lap belongs to her. Makam Kalasa Kanila, and her basket also belongs to her. What does this mean? Amar Rava, my time at the Rabbi Yochanan. Lefisha ain't all the makbid. Loyal Makam Cheka, loyal Makam Kalsa. A man is not makbid on the lap or on the basket. Don't make a difference to him. He allows that, his wife, to have that. So therefore, when you throw the get into her lap or into her basket, the husband is perfectly fine with that. But the
even
point,
if he's, even if he's divorcing her,
yeah, that, yeah. I mean, he's the one divorcing her. So.
Divorcing her.
I mean, he's the one that wants her to get divorced.
He doesn't want to grant her anything.
Right.
He wants to grant her the divorce. However that might be, he wants to do it.
Okay.
Yeah.
By the way, the Tosfos Kunchai Baal Mecha Colossus, he says at the end of what you were saying before, that even though you don't, there's no pinion on the karka over here, or there's no pinion over here, even though she doesn't own the makam, but since you have reshus to put your things there, then you're able to be kinda. Just like a simta, even though you don't own the simta, but the kli could be kind of in the simta. Exactly what we were saying before.
You're saying, okay, I hear.
But yeah, because Tosis says, "What? How is it going to help? Lamai, you need a chazaka to be kind of karka." So Tosis says, "No, you don't need to be kind of the makam. You need to have the rishus to put your stuff there."
Right. I hear. Okay, that's good.
Yeah,
that's good. But anyway, so we have no raya. So the Gemara says, "Okay, ela pasha lo meha." Why don't we learn it from this? Pirshus Moicher, Loikana, Achi Yigbiano, Ayachi Yasim in Rishus. Right? So the Bryce said that if it was in the Rishus Moicher, then you're not Kaina until you pick it up or until it comes out from her, from his Rishus. What does that mean? My La Bekalem de Lekeach. Are we not talking about where it's in the Kalev of the Lekeach? And he said that you're not Kaina in the seller's Rishus until he takes it out. So our answer is like the kalem of the meicher. No, it's talking about in the kalem of the meicher. Okay, so if we're saying in the reisha, it's talking about in the kalem of the meicher. So then the reisha be kalem of the meicher, seifa now be kalem of the meicher. So that means the seifa, you have to try and have the brisa to be, the brisa has to be uniform. So if the reisha is talking about in the kalem of the meicher, so then the seifa also. Same as seifa. Then what about the seifa? Rishus lekeach. Let's say he took it with the rishus of the lekeach. It was in the rishus of lekeach. I mean, he poured the beer using our example. He poured the beer into the cup. Kiven shekibal olav meicher, since he was the meicher was mekabel it kana lekeach. The lekeach is kainet. He bekalev the meicher, and if we're talking about the kalem of meicher, I'm my kana lekeach. Right, you have to say the ratio is talking about the kalem of the meicher. So therefore, the buyer is not kainet until it comes into his rishus. Fine. So that means the sefer when we say. When it's in the Rishus of Lekeach, since he's makabel, it becomes his. But if it's in the Kalim of the Meicher, so why is it become his? So you want to answer Seifa Asan the Kalim of the Lekeach. The Seifa is talking about the Kalim of the Lekeach. So now we are making the Brisa not uniform. The Reish is talking about Kalim of the Meicher. The Seifa is talking about Kalim of the Lekeach. So the Gemara says, "Oh, my Piska." Well, who gives you, what's the psak? Meaning, who gives you the right to say that the resha is the meicher, the kalim of the meicher, and the seif is the kalim of the lekeach? So the Gemara answers, stama de milsa, it's stam, it makes sense. Bein meicher, because what's the resha talking about? The kalim are in the rishus of the meicher. So then whose kalim are being used in the rishus of the meicher? Lechaira, the meicher. It's bein meicher, mani, the meicher shlichi. Mani means kalim. That's, it's common that you're using the kalim of the meicher. And by the lekeach, then it's normal for the purchase for the buyers, Kalin, to be used. So therefore, we still have no raya. We have no raya if the kalim of the lekeach are in the reshus of the meicher, if that's his or not. Yeah. Okay. Hopefully that was understandable. We'll stop over there. Yeah.